And when a person lives a life of disobedience, lives a life of sin, as the hadith of Tamim Udari says, that the angel will come in the most awful of forms to this fasiq, to this fajr, to this kafir, to this munafiq. It will come in the most awful of forms. As Imam Qurtubi says, that the angel of death is so frightening, is so scary, that all the angels in the heaven fear the angel of death more than one of you fears a lion, fears a beast. And when the angel of death, when it comes to a fajr, when it comes to a kafir, when it comes to a munafiq, when it comes to a zalim, it will come in such form that his feet will be on the ground and his head will be in the heaven. 12 eyes, black of face, fire leaping out from his mouth, coming out from his nose. He'll have a forked iron rod made out of fire. He'll have 500 angels behind him with whips and embers made out of fire. And when it comes to a fajr, when it comes to a kafir, when it comes to a munafiq, or when it comes to a zalim, there's no addressing with assalamu alaikum. The angel of death will strike him with his forked iron rod. And this forked iron rod will enter his body. And when he enters his body, he'll enter every single vein, every single joint. As Abdullah says, radiallahu anhu, that when this forked iron rod is struck on him, and he enters every single vein, every single joint, it will reach the heart, and it will tear the veins from the heart. And that time the person becomes insane, he becomes mad. And then the angel of death begins to twist it. He begins to twist it. And when he begins to twist it, causes the veins in the heart to burst. And then the angel of death will start taking his soul out. Starting from his feet, stopping at his ankle. The body will faint. And when he comes back around, 500 angels will come with whips and embers made out of fire, and they will beat him. And then the angel of death will take the soul out from the ankle to the knees. Yet again, he will faint. And when he comes back around, 500 angels with whips and embers made of fire, they will beat him. And then the angel of death will take his soul out from his knees to his waist. Yet again he will faint. And when he comes back around, 500 angels with whips and embers made out of fire, they will beat him. And then from the waist to the chest, the angel of death will rip his soul out, and the body will swoon, he will faint. And when he comes back around, 500 angels with whips and embers made out of fire, they will beat him. And then the angel of death, he will take the soul out from the chest to the collarbone. Yet again, the body will, he will faint, the body will faint. He will fall in a swoon. 500 angels will come with whips and embers made out of fire, and they will beat him. And when he comes back around, the angel of death, he will put this ember made out of fire underneath his neck. And he will say to him, come out to the fire of hell, where there's scorching winds, scalding water, shadow of black smoke, no cool, no refreshing. And then the soul will be ripped out. And once the soul is ripped out of the body, what will happen? The body and the soul will begin to fight. And the army of Iblis will be celebrating. They will be celebrating. And then the coffin from the fire of hell will be bore, rough, rigid. It'll be bore from the fire of hell. and this person will be wrapped around it. And then the body will be lifted by the angels from the heaven. They will come down and they will lift his body. And when the body is lifted, every place where he committed sin, whether it was in Bullring, whether it was in Palisades, whether it was in Falls Hill, whether it was in Coventry, whether it was on Alam Rock Road, all the places will speak out and they will say, good riddance, you got rid of this disgusting soul. And the angels will take this soul and they will take him to the first heaven. And on the way, they will be calling him by the most disgusting of names that has been ever been called on the dunya. And when he reaches the first heaven, the angel will say, who is this impure, stinky, smelly, disgusting soul? And the angel will reply, he's the son of so and so. And then, regarding the disbeliever, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited the verse of the Quran, and he says, never would a kafir enter Jannah until a camel enters the eye of a needle. Would a camel ever enter the eye of a needle? Never. And then a voice is called from the heavens, and it will be said, write his name in the scrolls of hell, and his body will be thrown down. And now is time of grave. The hadith recorded by Imam al-Bukhari, Asma ibn Abi Bakr radiallahu anha, she says, one occasion I headed towards the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and all of a sudden the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was giving a sermon. And when the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was giving a sermon, there was an uproar. And you know what this uproar was? There were the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were crying. And you know why they were crying? Asma ibn Abi Bakr radiallahu anha, she says, they asked the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she says, I asked him, may Allah be pleased with you, tell me, what was the last thing that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? She says that the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed me, that the last thing that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said before this crying was that you will go through fitna in your grave similar to the fitna of the Antichrist. And the likes of Umar, being Amirul Mu'mineen, so brave he was, so strong he was. Umar, one of the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says that we were with Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu. On an occasion, we were taking a janazah to a graveyard. And when we reached the graveyard, Umar ibn Khattab, he walked in and he began to cry. And he sat next to an old grave. And when he sat next to an old grave, he says, I went to him. I went to Umar, Amir al-Mu'mineen, tell me what makes you cry? What makes you so sad? He says that the grave has addressed me. I went near the grave and the grave has addressed me. And the grave has said to me, though Amir al-Mu'mineen, why don't you ask me regarding those people who are inside me? Oh Umar, do you know what I do with them? Do you know what I do with them? I dismember their bodies into pieces. I take away their shrouds, I tear away their shrouds. I suck out all their blood and I devour their flesh. Oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, do you know what I do with the joints? I dislocate the shoulders from the arms from the forearms, and the forearms from the wrist, the hips from the waist, the thighs from the knees from the shin from the ankles. This is why Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu was crying. Because he reminded him of the grave, and the grave addressed him. And Umar, being a strong man, he begins to cry. Tears were flowing from his eyes. And now, when the soul is in the grave will say, your coming is evil. I'm displeased to meet you. Out of all those people that passed me, you were the one. You were the one I hated most. You have come to me today. Today I will show you how I will treat you. And when the soul is in the grave, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the grave will become dark, and at that time the grave will squash him. The grave will squash him and his ribs will interlace. And then the angels, as Jibreel alayhi salam says, they will come in the grave. And you know what their description is? Their eyes flash like the flash of lightning. Their voices rumble like thunder. Their canine teeth looks like the bull's horns. And when they speak, fire comes out. And they've got a hammer with them so heavy that if every single person on the face of this earth got together and tried moving an inch of this hammer, they would not be able to do so. And then these angels will come to this person, this Fajr, in such a manner that the person in the grave, his body will begin to shake, his bones will crackle, his limbs will move from his places, and he will faint. Yet again the angels will approach him in such a manner, they will make him sit again. They will make him sit again, and they will say to him, you have left the world. Yet again his bones, his body will begin to shake, his bones will crackle, his limbs will move from his places, and he will fall again. Yet again the angels will come to him again, at this time. Yet again they will approach him in such a manner that his bones will begin to shake, his limbs will move from his places, and the angels will grab him and they'll make him sit, and they'll say, you have left the world and you have come to your temporary station. Answer our questions. Tell us, who is your Allah? Who is your Lord? And the person will say, Arjuna. Why? Because he lived a life of disobedience, he lived a life of sin, living a life chilling out, cruising around with the boys. He had no time for Allah. And the angels will say, they will pose the second question to him, and they will say, what is your deen? Yet again, he will say, I do not know. Why? Because he lived a life of disobedience, he lived a life of sin, living a life cruising around with the boys. He didn't know what deen was, because he was too busy in Palisades, in Bullring, in Coventry, in Falls Hill. He had no time for Allah. And they will say, and the third question will be fired by the angels. Who was this man who was sent amongst you? Yet again, he will say, I do not know. Why? Because his role models were Tupac, his role model was 50 Cent, his role model was Jay-Z. He followed their sunnah, the gold rings, the funny haircuts, the dodgy clothes. He didn't follow the sunnah of Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He didn't know what sunnah was. And he will say, I do not know. And the angels will say, is that the case? They will grab this fork, they will grab this hammer, this steel hammer, and they will strike him, and they'll give him such a beating that his grave will be full of fire.